I'm so honored and grateful once again to introduce Pastor Lance West to many. And this is my mama. I met Pastor West in the early 2000s, and my mother talked highly of him, that he's the best and the kindest young man. And she went on and on and on. And I would see him throughout the years after she passed, and I was just like, wow. But I concur with mama, that I have been so favored to meet this man of God who loved my mother and loved all God's people. So he agreed to come on this sixth season of Let Your Light Shine, and he has encouraged me. Our dialogue has increased my mindset even the more, and I'm so excited to share him. Enjoy. God is merciful, but this is our time to chat here at Healthy Heart on the sixth season, and ain't no shame in our game. We done been saved, filled with the Holy Ghost, so we get ready. Well, to God be the glory. I'm enjoying life, Pastor West.
Yes, good.
I really am. I really am.
And you can see it. Woo! You can see it on
boy. You. Okay.
See, I like your dress too.
I know. I like them. I am doing.
You just do your thing. Self care is. It's so important.
And to realize, find out who you are and who you ain't. Because you can mess around and pretend to be who you ain't and wake up and be lost.
Lord have mercy.
Oh, man, just because you're fitting in where you get in. Right. But anywho, this is, and that's kind of sort of, it all ties together.
Absolutely.
This is the sixth season about being lit. Mm-hmm. And it's based on Matthew 5 and 16. And a young person said, Miss Cha-Cha, you don't even know what that means. Being lit means you get ready to get high. Mm-hmm. And I said, baby, I know what it means. I'm already high on the Holy Ghost.
That's right.
So anyway, I asked Pastor West, and he says, yes. And I'm so grateful. And I listen to him on Sunday mornings on my way to my destination. And I can hear his voice. And somebody was talking about you the other day. And I forget what choir she done put you in, Mississippi, somebody's choir. She was saying, you know that pastor, he needs to be in one of them southern choirs. She didn't say choir, she said choir. So anyway, I'm going to zip it because I am just so excited. And I'm learning even the more about the light, the capital L-I-G-H-T. So one thing I did, he walked in the door and I said, hi, how are you? But then another thing that I asked him right off, how do you let your light shine? Or do you have to let your light shine when you're around a whole bunch of people that know everything? Or do you just sit back in the cut?
That's right.
What do you do with that?
Jesus said, let your light so shine that men may see it. You don't have to make it shine. You just let it shine. And they'll see your good works, and then they can focus on glorifying the Father, which is in heaven. So
I don't have to try to press my way in there to show that I'm just as smart as everybody else.
No, your light will shine as a result of your connection with Christ. That's so important. We've got so many people connected to other things and not connected to Christ. And that's so important for us to know that Christ is the answer. And without him, we can do nothing. So, well, and what I wanted to, come and talk about today, and as we discuss the Gospel of John. I'm sorry, Gospel of John, where John emphasizes the personality. John emphasizes light and darkness. John and his personality. He's when he writes his letters, write the gospel. The theme is John is a one that's no gray area. It's either light, darkness, truth, error. John makes it very clear, and I think we have to be clear in John writing in the gospel to the church and letting the church know, and he talks about the importance of making sure that we are connected to the light so that in order for our light to shine, we got to know something about the word, the logos.
All right.
It's a Greek word, which means that communicating the truth about who God is. John says, in the beginning was the Word, the Word was with God, the Word was God, and the Word was in the beginning God, with God, and all things was made by him, and there was not made anything that was made. And then he says that once you know about the Word, and the more you know about the Word, the better your light will shine.
Wow, that's deep.
And the closer you get to that word, the brighter your light will shine.
Quit it. So it's a progression.
It's a progression based on you. Jesus said, if you abide in me and my word abide in you, you should ask what you will. Hmm. It shall be given unto you.
That's deep.
And he said, I'm the vine, you're the branch. And without, if you won't bear much fruit, apart from me, you can do nothing.
So is that how you go from glory to glory?
How you go from glory to glory. You got to stay. You got to know about the word and let that word become a part. Not just, Jesus, if you abide in me and I abide in you. In other words, you got to remain attached to me. And you got to let him remain attached and allow his word to saturate your life. So everything you saying and doing and acting and looking at is being done through
and
that light.
Looking at even in the dark.
Right. Because he sees, the Bible says that God sees in the dark as well as in the light. So that's
deep. That. No getting around that.
They're not getting around it. And we have to allow ourselves to understand. Because John makes it clear in his gospel, in John chapter 20, 21, he says this, and I'm read a couple of passages because I want to make sure that we get with the word of God, because I don't have anything to say.
You the voice.
John, just a voice.
Voice. Crying out.
In the woo! That's all I am. I'm just trying to lift him up. So John 21 and verse 24 and 25 said, contemporary English verse said, this disciple is the one who tells all of this. He wrote it, and we know he's telling the truth. Verse 25, Jesus did many other things. If they were all written in the book, I don't suppose there would be enough room in the whole world for all the books. So John, and then he goes in chapter 20 and said, this is the purpose of why I wrote this book. Now, everything that Jesus did could not be recorded, John said. So Jesus did everything. He did more miracles than what was recorded. But John said that if we took time to try to record all of that, we wouldn't have enough volumes. It wouldn't be enough libraries. But we do have enough. We have enough light to see.
Oh, man, you better preach. You better tell it.
Because, see, here's the thing John is trying to get us to see. That if you're going to see the light, you got to, first of all, you got to believe it, believe the word. In order to see what God is doing.
Wow.
Because he said to Thomas, you believe because you've seen, but blessed are those who have believed and have not seen. So believing opens your eye to see, because that's what the light does. It illuminates.
Yes.
It gives direction, gives perception, allows you to see. So it opens your eye, but you got to believe it.
Yeah.
Then you can see it.
And something you said that helps me too is, even after you believe it and you see it, you got to keep seeing.
You got to keep seeing, because you got to keep on seeing what God is able to do. See, God is not, and the more he allows you to see, the more revelation he revealed to you, the stronger your faith becomes. Because what John talked about, the man that was born blind, John said, I don't know what I'm saying. I don't know if he's a sinner or not. But what I know is that I was blind, but now I can see. And as he got closer to Christ, what he said about it, he said, he was just a good man, good prophet. Then when they put him out of the temple, he said, now I know he's the Son of God.
Shut up. Shut up. I didn't know that. See, you're never too old to learn.
See, the progression.
The word is rich.
And it's all in John. It's not all. And what I'm going to be citing is what John is saying to back up what he said, that everything that Jesus did in the book, it couldn't be written, everything. So we got to understand that what we have enough is God has given us enough if we believe what's already in that. And John said, this is the purpose of my book. John chapter 20, verse 30 and 31, he says, Jesus worked many other miracles for his disciples, and not all of them are written in this book.
Wow. Is that applicable to us right now?
Absolutely.
I mean, that's not written in the, it's applicable.
Right now. Because what God is, because see, the miracle is, can only be ascribed to what God has done. You can't be linked to your ingenuity, can't be linked to what you know, your connection. It has to be something that goes against logic in what you're doing.
Oh, man.
And it can only be subscribed to God. God can only be the one that does it.
That's good news. And that's good news because sometimes I think one might read the Bible and not see how it's applicable right now.
Because
if
right
it's
now.
Not applicable right now, it's like, oh, it's a good story.
Right. It's a good story. Hmm. But it's right now that he can.
That's why we gotta let our light shine, ain't it?
That's why we gotta let our light
shine.
Shut
up.
Because we are miracles.
Who?
We're miracles. He translated us from darkness into light.
Hmm.
He brought us out of darkness to his marvelous light.
Boy.
So John says, but verse 31, but these are written so you might put your faith in Jesus Christ as the Messiah, the one who has come to set us free,
yes, sir.
And the Son of God.
Hmm.
And if you have faith in him, you will have life.
Wow, life.
Because life. See, because life is what helps us to reveal the light.
Hmm, that's deep. I got you on that one.
Our light. See, life. Our life has to be connected with him who is life.
Okay.
So that the light can shine through us as we do what he tells us
that's
to
rich.
Do.
So when you said that, it made me think of Mama, even though she's gone to be with the Lord. But her life still continues in what she invested in me. Boy.
And that light is shining in you. That's what I'm saying. That light is shining in you because it's a reflection.
Look at God.
It's a reflection.
Look at God. So when it's done, it ain't done.
No, because that light is going on. I'm saying. And that light goes on from generation to generation. Woo. As you connect the light.
So when we don't, we're being selfish and we're just being disobedient.
We're being disobedient.
Okay.
Because he said, let your light so shine. That's a command. Let it shine. Don't make it shine. Let it shine. Because
God is wonder if you're saved, maybe, if you don't do it. I guess you can be saved. You know, you see some people. I had a pastor one time. He said, y'all look like y'all been sucking on persimmons or something, like lemons. Mm-hmm. Everybody's. And it's like, well.
You can have joy. I'm saying having the light does not mean you don't have joy. You have joy. You want to enjoy. God is giving all things for us to enjoy.
All right.
All things. But we have to make sure that whatever we're doing, we put it under the light.
Ooh. So it's exposed.
So the light can be examined what's being done.
Shut up.
See.
Shut up.
You won't make. See. When I use, you know, handle money, one thing you can do if you handle money, what they tell you to make distinction between what's real and what's fake, hold it under the light.
Oh, man. And make sure you see the strip.
Image in that.
Quit it.
And you can't see the image is not the real
thing. Reject it.
That's right. You don't have to.
You ain't got to fight.
No. Hold it up to the light.
Mm.
Do you see the image of Christ in it?
Oh, Jesus. That's good. That's
and if you
rich.
Don't see the. Rejected.
But if you don't know what the image looks like,
you got to know the word. See, that's why John said in the beginning, he starts that as the premise before he opens as the prologue to the gospel. Before he writes it, he's saying that you got to get this basic down. That he's not just, we're not by evolution, you know, the word was in the beginning, whenever the beginning was.
Yeah.
We said faith. We believed. Mm-hmm. Because we believe, we're able to see that that's what God is able to do.
That's rich.
In the beginning, God. Mm-hmm. Before man was, in the beginning, God created the heaven and earth. So that word that God created, Jesus is that word, is God. Jesus gives God a face in the flesh.
That's rich. Face in the flesh. That's rich.
That's what the incarnation is about.
And the revelations that he drops in you to drop out, that's deep. I like that.
He gives God a face in the flesh.
Because we, as people, we want to see something.
We want to see, because God's invisible.
Yeah. Wow.
But the word was made flesh, John said,
and
dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, full of, watch this, grace and truth.
Woo.
And it has to be in that order.
So you don't get grace to love yourself.
And truth.
And in love, truth and love.
I said that's the essence of the nature of God.
Yeah. So we can't be, with representing him, we can't be popping off at people.
No, we got to speak the truth in love.
That grace case.
That grace and truth. It has to be full of grace and truth.
Mm. That's rich. I'm gonna ask you, I ain't gonna keep you forever. No. But I got something else. Yeah. So let's say you get on people's last nerve because they say it don't take all that. Is there ever too much light? You know, have you ever seen anybody that want to damper it, like the little light switch that you turn up and down? So how do you, what do you...
Okay, here's what the thing about...